Craig, I expected a lot more from this budget.
Well, I think this is a very modest budget. It does deliver on the core themes that the government had signaled in advance. This is about innovation and skills. But when we look at the amount of money the government has to spend on new initiatives, it's actually quite modest. And as a result, we're not hearing about large-scale new initiatives. What we're getting is very targeted small programs to address specific issues in the labor market and to try and promote innovation.
So it's basically the budget that clarified last year's budget.
Well, in addition to new announcements around innovation and skills, there's also a component of this budget that's really about providing more guidance about what they are going to do with money that they had previously announced. There's details around the money being spent on social infrastructure that was actually announced last year, but now we're getting greater clarity about how that money is actually going to be deployed.
So it's a matter of deciphering what's new money and what is old money.
Yeah, I think that's the big challenge in terms of reading the budget, that in some cases we're getting information that's really about money that had already been announced in budget 2016 or the fall fiscal update, but hasn't been spent yet. So they're telling us that now that money is going to be going out the door and what they're going to spend on. And then there's the new money, and this is the new initiatives that previously they hadn't announced. But in fact, those new initiatives are actually quite modest.
And how does the government keep that debt to GDP ratio on a downward track?
Well, the reason why this budget is so slim in terms of new announcements is that there just isn't money in the kitty to spend on new initiatives. Heading into the budget, Finance Minister Morneau was quite clear that he wanted the ratio of debt to the size of the economy on a downward track. And so what he was saying was, this government will run deficits for several years, but we're being financially responsible because the amount of debt relative to the size of the economy is going to be declining. Well, because of that, that also means that they actually don't have much new money to spend, because the last budget already took the debt to GDP ratio up. So going forward, the question is, you know, where are you going to get new money from? There are not big new tax measures to bring in new revenues. Where they are getting some additional revenues is cutting out some specific tax credits, inefficient tax credits. So for example, there was a tax credit for public transit that the prior government had introduced. I think a lot of Canadians are going to be disappointed that that's disappearing. But I think a lot of studies showed that the people that were benefiting it were people that were going to be taking public transit anyway. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, they're cutting some of those tax credits, and that's going to bring in a bit more money. They're also cracking down on tax evasion. That's going to bring in some money. But we're really talking small figures, and that basically hasn't left the government with much money for new initiatives on innovation and skills.